हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ चैप्टर नंबर 6, प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड दिस इज़ ऑफ 31st लेक्चर। सो आवर टुडेज पॉइंट इज क्लासिफिकेशन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ केमिकल नेचर एंड सोर्स ऑफ सप्लाई। सो क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ इनऑर्गेनिक इंसेक्टिसाइड्स। So there are the insecticides are classified according to the basis of chemical composition. So here it is three classes: inorganic insecticides, and actually second one is organic insecticides. But this is further divided into naturally occurring insecticides, that is plant origin, and second one is synthetic and organic insecticides. So inorganic insecticides, they generally acts as a stomach poisons. Some important inorganic insecticides are lead arsenate, calcium arsenate, Paris green, fluorides, etc. So inorganic insecticides comprise compounds of mineral origins and element sulfur. This group includes arsenate and fluorine compounds as insecticides. Sulfur as acaricides and zinc phosphides as rodenticides. So these are inorganic insecticides. The next one is organic insecticides. As we can see in this figure or in this chart, organic insecticides are insecticides of animal origin. So this is isolated from marine annelids, fish or fish oil, rosin soaps from fishes, etc. So it is plant origin insecticides or botanical insecticides, that is nicotinoids, which is derived from nicotine, pyrethroids, rotenoids, etc. Then third one is synthetic organic insecticides are organochlorine insecticides, organophosphorus, carbamate insecticides, etc. And last one is hydrocarbon oils, etc. These are organic insecticides. So inorganic insecticides, these are generated by inorganic species. First one as a type and second one is type. So as a type, arsenic containing insecticides, example lead arsenate, and second one is calcium arsenate. So what is lead arsenate? It was widely used for the control of the coddling moths. There are coddling moths and many other chewing insects. It is still employed for cotton insects. It is manufactured from litharge, that is lead oxide. It is very fluffy pink powder. In strong alkaline water, it undergoes following reactions which produces plant bones. So the reaction is PbHAsO4, that is lead arsenate plus water, it gives PbOH and AsO4 thrice plus H3AsO4. So it gives strong reaction, and in strong alkali water it undergoes this reaction and which produces plant burn. So our next is calcium arsenate. So it is white springly soluble substances. It contains 40% of As2O5. The phytological effect is diminished by addition of zinc oxide and zinc sulfate. They get decomposed easily after application to plant surface. These acts by inhibiting enzymes containing the sulfhydryl or coagulates proteins. So uses of this compound or calcium arsenate is, the calcium arsenate is employed for certain cotton insects. Okay, so cotton, it is used for cotton insects and cuddling moths, how to control the cuddling moths. So third one is Paris green. That Paris green is also inorganic insecticides. It is copper acetoarsenate. It forms a heavy powder settling in water unless well agitated. It is removed rapidly from foliage by weathering. It decomposed by water, carbon dioxide and ammonia. It is generally used as a dust powder. It can be mixed with Bordeaux mixture, but not with lime sulfur. So what are uses of Paris green? The Paris green is used against codling moths, potato beetles and surface feeding leaves. Then next is fluorides. Fluoride is also inorganic insecticides. These fluorides are highly toxic in nature and used as a dust. In this fluoride, that fluoride is also classified into sodium fluoride, sodium fluosilicates, then sodium fluoaluminates, and different types of another compounds are also there. In this page we can see the C, that is F type inorganic insecticides which contains fluorine containing insecticides. First one is NaF, that is sodium fluoride, then sodium fluoaluminate, that is Na3LF6, and Na3LF6 and Na2SiF6, then Paris green, then ethylene oxide, etc., and cryolite is also F-type insecticides. So this sodium fluoride contains 45.2% of fluorine and is less soluble in water. It is used against cockroaches, chewing lices, toxicants in poison baits. Then next one is sodium fluosilicates. So sodium fluosilicates contains 60.6% of fluorine and it is very less soluble. So in water, that's why it is used as a moth proofing. So next one is sodium fluoaluminate, that is Na3LF6, which contains 54.2% of fluorine and it is very low soluble. The solubility of this compound is very low in water, that's why it is used as a general stomach poisoning and spray and dust. So next one is organic insecticides or naturally occurring insecticides, which is plant origin. As we have already seen in classification chart, there are three types. First one is inorganic insecticides, then naturally occurring insecticides, which is plant origin, and third one is synthetic organic insecticides. So here it is naturally occurring insecticides, which is plant origin, we will discuss. Some plant materials have been most widely used as insecticides. The roots, stems, leaves of flowers are first dried and then finely ground. So we can use that material as a insecticides. These are used as such or sometimes the essential oil extracted from plants are used as a attractants or repellents. The important natural insecticides are as follows. First one is nicotinoids, which contains nicotine. It is C10H14N2. So this is naturally containing insecticides which contains nicotine, pyrethrins, which is C21H28O3, and rotenone, that is C23H22O6, etc. The next group is synthetic organic insecticides. These are synthetically generated, such as chlorine containing compounds, phosphorus containing compounds, and organo compounds. So first, chlorine containing compounds contain DDT, linden, eldrin, etc. Phosphorus containing compounds contain TEPP, dithione, etc. And last one is organocarbamates, also affects insects' nervous system. Example, isolin, car, organocarbamate, carbamate, bile, etc. So it is classification of organic insecticides like natural and synthetic. So we will discuss naturally occurring insecticides, that is plant origin. In this structure or in this picture, we can see botanical insecticides. It is also naturally occurring insecticides or plant origin. here we can see neem oil bottle or neem leaves or the extract neem leaves, so that oil can extracted through this neem leaves, and these insecticides are naturally occurring, which is chemically extracted from seeds, flowers, leaves, stems and roots, and termed as a botanical insecticides, which is because it is naturally occurring insecticides or plant origin insecticides. In this structure or in this diagram, we can see neem oil, then natural insecticides, integrated pest management, then next one is again neem oil is there, then home garden insecticides or insect sprays are also there to kill bugs on plants or different types of insects. So here in this picture we can see different types of insecticides which are available in market, and all these insecticides are plant origin. That is why it is naturally occurring insecticides. So now discuss, first is nicotine. So what is nicotine? It is also plant origin insecticides or nicotinoids, that is 1-methyl-2,3-pyrrolidine, that is nicotinoids. The major constituents of this insecticide is nicotine, which is C10H14N2. On this page we can see the structure of nicotine, that is C10H12N2. So nicotine has been used as an insecticide since at least the 1690s in the form of tobacco extract. Nicotine constituents approximately 0.6 to 3% of the dry weight of tobacco. It is extracted from tobacco leaves. The content of nicotine in tobacco leaf varies from 5%. In bland variation, it is high as 15% in some Algerian samples. The average range is between 2 to 3% of nicotine, which is present in all stages and in all parts of the tobacco plant. So what are the properties? Pure nicotine is a colorless, nearly colorless liquid alkaloid, and boiling point of that nicotine is 247.3 degree, with specific gravity 1.00993. This compound is soluble in water in all properties below 60 degree and above 210 degree centigrade. Where it forms hydrates, it is soluble in alcohol, ether, chloroform and petroleum oil. It is present in tobacco as salts of malic and citric acid. It is 5 to 7 times as a toxic as nicotinic sulfate or hydrochlorides. So what are its uses? It is contact insecticides. It is used as a contact insecticides and acts as a fumigant when applied in the form of spray or dust. It paralyzes the nervous system of the insects and causes convulsions and death. So next is pyrethrum extract. It is in this figure we can see a flower, that is pyrethrum, and that insecticides or that extracts from that pyrethrum flower we can use as a insecticide. So pyrethrum is a flower. A pyrethroid is an organic compound similar to natural pyrethrins, which are produced by the flowers of pyrethrums. So pyrethroids are used as a commercial and household insecticides. In household concentration, pyrethroids are generally harmless to human. Pyrethroids are toxic to insects such as bees and dragonflies, mayflies, gadflies and some other invertebrates. So what are properties of pyrethrum? The pyrethrum is extracted from the ground flower seed, coccinum and certain plants of chrysanthemum genus family. So it is extracted from chrysanthemum genus family. It has been used for control of harmful insects for many centuries. So dust concentrates are made from concentrated pyrethrum extract with a non-volatile solvent and a suitable absorbent, and then diluted before use with an with an inert dilutant. Antioxidants such as tannic acid, hydroquinone are used to stabilize it, this preparation. So what are its uses? That pyrethrum acts as a contact poison and a knockdown effect on either nerve or muscles of insects like cockroaches, resulting in muscular excitation, convulsion and paralysis. It is widely used to control aphids, jacids and household insects. It is non-toxic to mammals and non-injurious to plants. Insecticidal activity of pyrethrum is reduced by 49% to 68% when treated surfaces are exposed to sun lamp for 10 minutes and to air or sunshine for fires. The finer the powder, the more rapid is its action on insects. The insecticidal activity of pyrethrum is associated with 5-ester pyrethrum first and second, cinerins first and second, jasmolin second. So here we have discussed pyrethrum extract or pyrethrinol. Then our third one insecticide is rotenoids. Rotenoids are naturally occurring substance containing a cis fused tetrahydrochloromino, that is 3,4-B chromine nucleus. Many have insecticidal activities such as prototypical member of this family, rotenone. So rotenoids are related to isoflavones. Here in this diagram we can see the structure of rotenoids. They are colloquially rat poisons, colloquially rat poison intended to kill rodents. Rotenone is a crystalline substance extracted from finely ground plant material with ether or chloroform solvent. It is present along with other rotenoid compounds of laser activity. It can be mixed directly with a mineral oil basis, example warfarin, monofluoroacetate and zinc phosphide etc. So what are the properties of rotenoids? Pure rotenone crystallizes from alcohol having melting point 163 degree centigrade. That pure rotenone is soluble in chloro organic solvents excepting CCl4, that is carbon tetrachloride. It is insoluble in water. It gets easily decomposed due to its complex structure. The colorless solution of rotenone in organic solvent becomes successively yellow, orange and finally deep red when exposed to light and air as a result of oxidation or because of oxidation. So what are its uses? This rotenone acts as a contact insecticides or contact poison and as a stomach poison. It extracts its activity by blocking oxidative phosphorylation. So it is used to control aphids, thrips and caterpillars affecting vegetable drops. So dairies is usually used as a dust containing 0.5 to 1% of rotenone and as an emulsifier. So concentrate containing 1.5 rotenone. It is slower in action and breaks down quickly when exposed to light. Rotenone and other related compounds are considerably more toxic to insects, fish, cold-blooded animals and then to mammals. So here we can finish our organic or plant origin naturally occurring insecticides part. So in our next part we will discuss synthetic or organic insecticides. Thank you.